Hello guys and welcome back to XCOM 2. So just to recap, we've done a couple of missions as well as the tutorial. I mean, I think the tutorial was just the first mission, I'm not entirely sure. Although you're kind of forced to do the first two missions. We've got a kind of what would be called a council mission, I guess, but it's not really a council mission because there's no such thing as a council anymore. And we basically have to extract this VIP from the holding cell over here. We have 12 turns to extract them and take them to the exit point over here. So that's quite difficult, actually. I'm not really looking forward to this. I hate the missions where you have a kind of time run. I mean, I don't hate them as in like, oh no, God, I'm not going to do this. But it just brings me back to the one where you have to kind of defuse the bomb, and it took me God knows how long to actually kind of do that mission. It was super tough. We've got our four soldiers here. We've got a heavy, a sharpshooter, a support, and also a rookie because our kind of assault was injured last time. So I guess we can kind of sprint these guys out because hopefully they're not going to get spotted, because in this XCOM, if you're unaware, you start off concealed. So it's not like the first XCOM where you kind of have to tread carefully, because the enemies are almost hunting you. You have to kind of move around and kind of do that. But in this one, you can kind of set up ambushes and things like that for them, which is super cool. I do like the fact that they just jump off that building like that. That's very cool. And Eva, you're gonna go over here.
Time to motor.
Okay. So I have no idea what's gonna happen in these missions. I think we got a little bit lucky on the first couple. So we could get up on the roof here. Roof might be an option, actually. I think we got a little bit lucky in the first couple of missions. We managed to escape without any deaths, but
go, go, go.
I'm going to try and leg it over here, see if I can get this one up on the roof. And Jack Brown's going to go over here. And we've got some doors there. I think you break concealment as soon as you hit the doors, though. He's our Australian sniper. These guys here I'm a bit worried about. So I want to try and stay off to the left, I think. Again, I have no idea if this is a good thing or not.
Let's do this.
So Eva, I think we want to get up on the roof. I think we can get, yeah, we could probably get down there. That might be quite cool, actually. Might take her and I might take one of the others up there. Ooh. So it looks like we've got some aliens over there. I mean, if we can avoid these aliens, then I'm all for that.
Closing on target position now.
And just, you know, sneak in, get the guy out, and do it that way. So I'm going to send Jack Brown over, our sniper. It's good to have a sniper up on the roof, get a good view. And then I might... Am I going to take these guys then? Because as soon as I open a door, I come out of concealment. From what I can see in here, though, there's no one around in here. We need to get in there. Now I think we can climb down there and that gets us inside. Yeah. Is the roof going to be the way for everyone? Can we climb up on the roof around here? Oh, we can there. Okay. So there's an entry point there, right? Let me just... Oops. There we go. Right, okay. So yeah. I think we go roof. Again. No idea if this is a good 10-4. plan to keep everybody together. I mean, you know, it might be better to keep people apart to try to flank enemies a bit better, but we'll see. I don't think there's anybody up on the roof, so I don't think we're going to break concealment being up there. Okay. Let's get to there. And we can see what we can see.
That doesn't look like something you'd use to help someone, does it?
Not really. So, that's the cell right there. So if we can... I mean, I don't know if there's anybody down here. This is a totally risky move. I'm just going to pop her there. Because it's a dash, I can't move her back if we get spotted. But we'll know in a sec. Hang on a second. Is that she saw somebody? No, she hasn't spotted an enemy. For that, there's the sounder. I'm actually very nervous. God, yeah. How do we switch to the guys? Here we go. Next soldier. Tab. Okay, I'll remember that. Okay, so we want to get these guys down in here.
Got it.
So this is super cool, though. I do like the fact that this kind of... Alright, could use the ladder. Fancy. I do like the fact that they've kind of changed this to a...
Got it covered.
This kind of almost stealth tactic thing. You know, before in XCOM, it was... I mean, I assume there's going to be, you know, lots of different missions, different variations and things like that, because before in XCOM it was very much, let's get all the way over to the door, sod it, let's do it. We've only got a few number of turns, so. Now.
Be advised, hostile interceptors are inbound on your current position. Firebrand has a limited window to provide extraction.
Okay. But all we have to do is get there. Here's a question though. Can we get back up on the roof and then get down so we're still in concealment? Is that a good thing to do? Okay, hack.
Breaking their security.
This may well take me out of concealment actually, so it might be irrelevant. What the hell is the Dark Event Project? The only thing we can do is unlock the door. 7% chances, you know. I'm not that much of a risk taker.
I'm in. They're on to us.
Yep. Okay.
We've got the VIP in tow. Moving to evac.
Menace 1-5 status confirmed. VIP is in tow. Proceed to the extraction point.
Okay. Yikes.
Roger that.
Put it there. It's Jack Brown. He's gonna go here. It's only half, but I don't think I've got full here. I was thinking about maybe putting him on the roof.
Affirmative, covering now.
But now we're exposed. Although I had a feeling he might not actually be exposed. I can't remember if I picked the perk where he stays concealed. That's my assault, actually. Should really think about these things. Okay, good. She can move over to there. We're not going to open the door yet. We're going to get her to Overwatch. But we'll just move Eva Romero first. Number one rule I learnt we'll move her to the door. Number one rule from XCOM 1 is don't Overwatch until you've moved everyone. So our VIP is going to go there. And Overwatch.
Moving to Overwatch.
Just in case. And yeah, we were I didn't expect them to come through that way. God damn it, man. Ooh, that is incredible. Wow. Yep, you can point all you want, mate. What's that?
Menace 1-5, we're picking up an enemy transport inbound on your current position.
Okay, so we got... I guess we got lucky there. RNG doing its thing. I think our sniper can take this shot. He's got a 75% chance. That's good. Fire. Yes. Critted as well. I would like to get that loot, but that ain't gonna happen. Open the door. Oh, poo. Should probably have overwatched and waited, but I'm just concerned with the number of turns. Okay, it's okay though. We've got some good shots on here. Now, if we launch a frag grenade out here, can we hit them both? Yes.
Catch.
Get it. Cool. Now we're going to rely on our support here to take out and do the rest of the damage to this sectoid. 50. That's not a good percent. And also we need to basically almost crit to, well, we can't crit, but we need to do the maximum amount of damage on it to get in there. Eek. Let's do it. Missed. Oh boy. That's not good. Where can I move my VIP to? There, I guess that's full cover. We'll get him to hunker down as well. Now, we've still got Lillian. But we don't really have anywhere. Actually, that probably would be a good place there. Damn. I kind of screwed that. Thinking, like, where can we send her? That's going to... These guys are only... Are these getting half or full cover here? I can't remember. Who gets, it should be full, I think. So I might move her to there and then overwatch it. It's just in case that sectoid tries to move. Here we go. These are the reinforcements. It's okay. Looks like just regular soldiers. We can take them. Get my grenadier. Just pop a grenade right in there. That would be pretty awesome. Let's take them all out. Okay, we've got the overwatch, let's see what happens. God damn it, you hit the wall. For God's sake, woman. Okay, it's going to raise a zombie. That's absolutely fine by me, because I can take that out next turn. And that will kill the zombie as well. Reanimated. Okay, cool. So, let's try and take out. No, we don't want to take that out. We want to take out that one. Yeah, that one. No, not that one. That one. 36. I've only got 36% chance to hit it. Ooh, this is dodgy. Does that mean they're on Overwatch? That little symbol there. I think it does, doesn't it? I can't move. Eek. Let's see what he's got. 3275. So you can take the zombie out. I need to take him out. I need to take this sectoid out, though. 32. I'm thinking grenade. The grenade will only do 3 damage. That'll leave me with 2 left. It's a guaranteed hit though, isn't it? So let's see who we've got who's got eyes on. So we know those two have here. So Eva, you've got a 39% You don't have a grenade because you got a med pack. That's fine. And we've got Lillian, who has a grenade as well. So worst comes to worst, we could do two grenades. I don't want to try and use my grenades, because I'd much rather try and use them for this kind of group here. But, you know, we do what is necessary. So, knowing that those two have got the grenades, they'll be the last people to go. And instead, we'll try and take out the alien here with a 36% chance. How do we do this? Or is it better to just take the alien out with the grenade, chuck these two on Overwatch, and then once those soldiers move up, we take our chances from there? Because what's going to happen here, we take these shots. Best case scenario, we take these shots. These two hit. Kill this guy. He goes down. Okay? Immediate danger out the way with. But we've got three soldiers coming in there. These two would be then overwatched, and as soon as they come into sight, we can do it there. So either way, it looks like we could, but the less riskier one is to grenade.
Fire in the hole!
Okay, did 4 damage actually. That's interesting. And we blew the cover of it. So now we've got a 59. I think I will take the chance on the weapon. If that one's got a 59 and that one's got a 56, we'll take the higher. Come on, let's do it. Yes, get in. So we killed them. Zombie's gonna go down. Yep. Awesome. Okay. And promotion earned. Okay. So now, do we take the shot? Or 50% chance is pretty good, or do we overwatch? I think we've got to take the shot, haven't we? I think we take the shot. God, that heavy is awesome. My gosh, she just doesn't miss. Okay.
Draining ammo fast.
Yeah, that's the one problem though. So Jack Brown, he's obviously moved. Lillian is gonna go on Overwatch.
Come get some.
He's gonna hunker down. And then hopefully one of these guys is gonna move into range and Overwatch is gonna take him out. Please? No, you hit a wall again.
Yeah, I didn't get it.
So these guys could get some shots off this turn. We just got to get lucky, basically. Okay, we lost that. That's fine. Actually, they wanted to overwatch and didn't shoot. Oh, this is big. Okay. 50% chance to hit, though. But they're on overwatch, so they've... Yeah, we can't get in there. So just to... So I know that's the overwatch symbol there. So we can't get in. And what's our sniper got? 55. We'll take that. We'll take a 55. Done. Awesome.
It's down.
So we've got 3 guys left. And this one doesn't have eyes on though. Does she? No, she doesn't either. So this is dangerous. I need this heavy to hit, and then I'm also out of ammo if she does. Oh my god, these 50% are like 100%.
Target disabled.
Now I'm well aware I'm getting lucky here, but
ammo out.
Okay, so is the question, if they came from that way already, are they going to come from that way again? Or I think
that's
we go there. And we overwatch.
Got it covered.
Our good friend cannot make it to there yet. I want to get them done quick. So I'm gonna risk it a little bit, but I'm gonna hunker down. I think they'll be okay.
Got it covered.
Oh shit! I didn't mean to overwatch. I meant to put him to hunker. Damn! I thought it was gonna give me the option to hunker down. Okay, well, I mean, at least we have someone back if necessary to flank. You know, trying to put a positive spin on it. Doesn't matter about our sniper too much, because at the end of the day, he can't... He could pistol overwatch, but, you know, doesn't do that much. And our heavy is going to reload. Okay, so it just takes one movement, does it? That's cool. But what I think I'm going to do for her is again put her on Overwatch.
Come get some.
And then we're going to put her on Overwatch. We've still got four turns. That's a good number of turns. Oh, did it switch to another turn? Ooh, okay. Okay.
Menace 1-5, hostile interceptors are on high-speed approach. Your window for extraction is closing.
Yeah, I got it. So I think I can get everybody over now. Where's my next soldier? Get him in there as well.
On the move!
You can leg it. Get the scientist in.
Run this one in.
Evac. Oh, cool. Evac.
I'm out of here.
Evac.
VIP secure and in position for evac. This is Firebrand. VIP is secure. Let's go.
Good to hear. Awesome. Okay, so I think that went pretty well. As long as we don't get any aliens now. Oh crap, they're coming. You gotta leg it inside there.
Orders confirmed, on the move.
Get in. Get out.
I'm out.
Be back. Ooh hoo hoo.
Status confirmed. Mission accomplished.
Cool. So we killed 8 out of the 10. The 2 we missed were the 2 if you went around the right hand side, but I think I'm okay with missing them, and we didn't get anybody wounded, no one got hit. In fact, they didn't even manage to take a shot, which is exactly the way we want it. Okay. Yeah, no one even managed to have a shot. Average damage per attack, 4.5, that's pretty good. Our heavy was definitely MVP, 100%. Doing good work there. And 75% successful shot percentage is good. There's 250%ers there. You know, you can go either way on that. So I'm happy, very, very happy so far that we managed to do that. And I think the roof entry was a good choice. Definitely. Let's go back to base, see what they got to say. I wonder if we get anything for this mission. Where are we going? And we got some promotions as well. So our squaddy. Okay, so what we're going to have. Long watch allows Overwatch to trigger with squad sight. Okay. Return fire. When targeted by enemy fire, automatically fire back with your pistol once per turn. Ooh. So the question is, do I want the sniper or do I want the gunslinger? Now, from what I remember, the sniper is... I mean, I don't know what XCOM 2 is going to do, because I've always felt like the sniper was very, very powerful in the first game. I always took a sniper and a gunslinger with me. The gunslinger was cool because they could move and then shoot. The sniper just had the squad sight, which was awesome. But I'm going to go the long watch. Yeah. Our rookie, what's she going to be? She's a ranger. Awesome. That's actually very cool. I think that suits her outfit as well. We have to make a red though for the Rangers. And promotion here. Medical protocol. The Gremlin can perform healing actions remotely. Gremlin heal and Gremlin stabilize. The Gremlin has a single charge. If a medkit is equipped, the Gremlin will gain an additional charge. Okay. And combat protocol. Send the Gremlin to an enemy to jolt them, dealing guaranteed damage, which is increased against robotic enemies. I think we're going for a support here, so we want the medical abilities. That sounds very useful. If we can get two heals from the Gremlin. Cool. So our squaddy didn't get any kills, but still got promoted. That's interesting. Do you just get promoted for going on a mission now? And our VIP, who looks a lot like the lady from... I can't remember which Star Trek movie it is, but you guys
Another
know the one I mean.
Impressive effort, Commander. My expectations the one with Voyager. Were high, and yet you have exceeded them.
Cool, okay.
Thank you for sending additional support staff to assist me, Commander. I will make sure they are put to good use.
Sounds a bit creepy, but we'll go with it. So, supplies are used to purchase weapons and armor for your soldiers and the facilities and upgrades you install on Avenger. To gain more supplies, sell items at the black market. Selling what you must is
more of the Advent Therapy Clinic. A few minutes under the knife and you've got a clean bill of health. Too bad you need a chip to get in.
Okay. So it looks like this is similar to the first one. Establish contact with regions around the world to raise your regular income. Yep, so that's like the different countries. Many missions like Supply Raise, Guerrilla Ops can offer large amounts of supplies as reward. These missions will appear regularly as you pass time. Okay. So, oh god, we only got $3. Where do we actually... Maybe it's in our quarters. No? It's got nice quarters though, I'll give them that. Command.
Commander.
Engineering. View inventory. Okay, can't sell it there. Just wondering where we actually get to.
I probably could have saved a lot of time repairing the ship's systems if we had any idea how to translate their language. Unfortunately, we don't come across many linguists out here.
Hello, Commander. Work is well underway, but it will be some time yet before my research is complete.
Well, it's going to be one day, isn't it?
Within the tight constraints of the Avenger, I've had a difficult time finding room to conduct some of our more theoretical experiments. Perhaps the next time we set down.
Okay. Let's go to the bridge. After a recent assessment, members of Resistance in East Asia have brought us reports of activity where we want to investigate.
Avenger sure. Plotting new course.
Let's investigate. Oh, where are we going?
These findings will likely prove crucial to our ongoing efforts, Commander.
Okay. So we've discovered modular weapons. We've had the troops digging through scrap piles and looting corpses, and at this point it's safe to assume they're on constant vigil for anything we could use to improve our gear. All the raw materials in the world won't mean much if we can't have a use for find a use for them, but I think this modular weapon system is a good start. Okay, let's see what this gives us. Okay. Oh, okay, so when we find those kind of upgrades, we can attach them to our weapons. That's quite cool. Plated armor. That sounds like that would be very useful. Magnetic weapons. I think I'm going to research
Knowing
these corpses. They're nice and quick.
Surgical experience is limited. I am sure the crew appreciates that I hone my skills on fallen Advent forces before triaging our own wounded. To the uninitiated, the common Advent trooper is seemingly human. The aliens have disguised this most glaring divergence from the human form with a carefully designed helmet.
Okay. Cool. Let's keep going, see what we find here. Hopefully we get some cash.
Power relay now operational.
Oh, power relay's done. Venture power capacity 3. New staff slot available. Increases the Venture power. Marguerite Baker is now available. Okay, looks good. So we might as well put her in there because we can't. Does it want me to click on that? No, we can't upgrade that. Because we can't build anything else because we haven't got any money. Otherwise, I probably would kind of take out some of these.
I have made a number of interesting discoveries, Commander.
Good. Let's have a look.
Despite a thorough analysis, I have yet to discover what, if any, advantage the Advent hybrid soldiers' enormous eyes provide. Testing their visual acuity will no doubt prove difficult.
Okay. So new items available. The battle scanner. Ooh. That's useful. And yeah, I think we want
to
research this.
Though I was never witness to one myself, countless observers attest to the existence of a much smaller, less intimidating variant of the sectoid that took part in the original invasion. In the time since, this new being, the product of clear genetic manipulation, is now a familiar face to our forces operating in the field.
Cool. Get back and get scanning. Okay, cool. We've got another scientist. Among the last holdouts in this area, a small group of resistance fighters known as the Fire Axis made contact while we were scanning the region. One of our soldiers claims to have known several members of the elusive group and was able to recruit one of their scientists to join Dr. Tigan's lab. Cool.
Setting course for Sector 14.
So our research speed has been increased by 25%. That's awesome. So we've got 2 days.
I do not think I could have predicted this outcome, though it is intriguing. The sectoid's rapid physical evolution over the past 20 years is a testament to both the aliens' mastery of genetic engineering and their pursuit of advancement, regardless of the risks.
Okay. So, preliminary autopsy exam conducted by Dr. Richard Tigan, acting science officer. Although my direct surgical experience is limited, the alien's genetic manipulation of the species previously catalogued as a sectoid provides a certain familiarity in the relation to human anatomy. While the earliest documented accounts of sectoids on Earth indicated examples no larger than 1 meter in height, the specimens we encounter today are all nearly twice that size. Knowing full well that the aliens continue their efforts to integrate human and alien DNA, my findings here only reinforce the notion of a continuous development process. This larger sectoid variant has an even greater proportion of human genetic material, selectively combined with the intention of improving the otherwise limited physical capabilities of the original with enhanced psionic capabilities and greater overall strength. I'd say they'd succeeded. Tigan. So now we have new item available, the mind shield, and we can research psionics. Okay, well that seems incredibly useful. A powerful psionic artifact rendering soldiers completely immune to any negative mental conditions, including panic, mind control, stuns, and disorientation. I guess we're going to go resistance communications. So how much do these mind shields cost?
When I have a full report available.
Hello, Commander.
45 supplies each. That's quite expensive, isn't it? Well, I guess it's okay. So I think we're getting some supplies tomorrow, so... The thing is, what I'm guessing is we're going to have to take out a grenade if we want to put one in.
Commander, we've got local resistance forces waiting to make contact, but we'll have to make the first move. Got an urgent communication coming in for you now, Commander.
Okay, except
you have made considerable progress against the aliens over the past month, Commander. I hope that your ongoing efforts will only lead to further success.
Awesome. So I guess that's the first month, is it, done? New staff available, so looks like we've maybe got a soldier and a scientist. We can recruit new staff at Resistance HQ. We've got $140, or whatever the hell that money is now. Cool.
Commander, we have intel suggesting the aliens are working on developments that threaten our ability to stop the Avatar project. We can conduct guerrilla operations to disrupt one of these efforts, but we'll have to choose carefully. We don't have the resources to intercede everywhere.
Okay, we have received intel regarding the aliens' current activities. Preparations to foil these dark events before they can be enacted are already underway. Hunter operations will be available soon. So, resistant informant. The aliens find a mile within the resistance, reducing the retaliation counter by 2 weeks. And then Advent rural checkpoints. Advent stifles the movement of resistance resources, decreasing the supplies of the next supply drop by 50%. So what, we have to choose one, or? Or the fact that that's just happening?
Resistance has a hidden cache of resources stashed outside of Advent's reach. But that means we'll have to fly over and scan the area if we want to recover this stuff for ourselves.
Avenger plotting new course.
We do want to recover that. It's just 3 days.
Nothing on the local comms. Advent's been quiet lately. I'm guessing we have you to thank for that.
Our pleasure, Den Mother. Enjoy it while it lasts.
We plan to. Our water purification.
Massive signal coming from the Advent Network Tower. It's global. Sir, I think you want to see this.
Fellow citizens, for 20 years, the Advent Coalition has worked tirelessly to repair the ravages and injustices of the old world. Under our stewardship, our cities prosper, our people flourish, and our world heals. And yet, among us, there are still those who would refuse to acknowledge the truth, who are determined to see all that we have achieved.
Multiple radar contacts on approach to Haven Alpha 7.
That must end. Even as I speak to you today,
you've got incoming on approach.
The signal's breaking up.
Outlying territories to end this scourge once and for all.
They're right on top of you.
Losing you, Avenger.
Raise them again!
We will ensure your continued safety and well-being throughout this crisis.
Get your people out of there!
With your cooperation, we will overcome these radical elements and usher in another 20 years of peace and prosperity.
They don't stand a chance. Commander, we should get a squad ready to deploy.
What the hell is that?
Commander, we have a squad ready to move on the Resistance Haven currently under